My name is Allison Wolff, and I work at NASA.
I have the coolest IT job at NASA, because what I get to do is take these ideas that these really smart people have and make them a reality. I manage a program called IT Labs. And in the IT Labs, what we essentially do is research and development of information technology. We will look at new technologies, computer systems, network improvements, cool applications or software, and we'll test them out and we'll see if these are things that we can use across the agency. We even get into some of the newer technologies like mobile applications, testing out things like iPads and iPhones and Androids. So it's a pretty broad scope of what we do, but it's all very exciting.
My name is Antja Chambers and I work at NASA. I work in the Portable Life Support Systems Group. That is a very long term for I work with the backpack that goes on the back of the suit. The backpack provides the cooling water, the breathing air, supply and return, as well as any other communication power that the spacesuit would need or the astronauts would need while they're in the spacesuits. The spacesuits in general are cool. There's so much. Basically, a spacesuit is like its own separate spaceship. It has to keep the astronauts alive. It has to, in very extreme environments, the vacuum of space is probably as extreme as they can come. And so I think it's just so cool thinking that you have this mini spaceship that is meant to sustain life.
My name is CJ Kanelakos and I work at NASA. I'm a mechanical design engineer and I work on Robonaut 2 actually. Robonaut 2 is a fully dexterous humanoid robot, and that just basically means that it looks similar to a human. It's about the same size as a human. It can work in the same workspace or the same area as a human. We currently have a Robonaut 2 on the International Space Station, but it's a torso and up, so it's just from the waist up to the head, and we are currently designing and building legs for Robonaut 2. I love that my job is challenging and it's engaging. It's really fun. Getting to build the robots is cool, you know, after we have our parts manufactured and we get to put them together and then you turn the robot on for the first time and you get to see it move, that's really cool. You know, like, we designed all these parts, we put together these bearings and motors and everything, and then all of a sudden it moves and looks like a robot.
Growing up, I did not consider math or science or technology to really be my thing. In fact, I was sometimes a little intimidated by it. I was very surprised to learn that not only did I really enjoy information technology, but I kind of had a knack for it. Which was a big surprise to me, considering that my background was art and writing.
When I was in sixth grade, I had a math teacher that really saw my potential for math. And she's the one that got me into the accelerated math programs. When I was in high school, though, one of my friends introduced me to our engineering team. I went to an all-girls private school. And so we had an all-girls engineering team. I found out that engineering actually can be kind of a combination of art and science and math. As a young female who really liked to draw and paint and do more artistic kind of stuff, engineering was a really good combination of those things.
I'm an Air Force brat. I've lived everywhere, probably moved maybe every 3 or 4 years. I was born in Germany, went to Japan, lived in England, and then my dad finally retired in San Antonio. And so I think that my exposure to a lot of the air shows, exposure to the aircraft that are on Air Force bases kind of sparked my interest in kind of heavy machinery, I guess you can say. And then it eventually grew into a genuine interest in space. I participated in a high school aerospace scholars program, which was then sponsored at Johnson Space Center, and still is, and it's still an ongoing program, where basically in my junior year I got a chance to spend a week at NASA and work with other teams. And that, I think, truly opened my eyes to wanting to actually finally go to NASA.
I really didn't know how technology influenced people's lives. I didn't really think that much about it. It wasn't until I got here and started learning about the applications for Robonaut 2 that I was like, wow, you know, there really are a lot of applications, even for the things that we do at NASA, but just in general, there's a lot of really cool applications for technology that just make a huge difference in people's lives.
Some fields don't seem like there's a lot of women present in them. Engineering is one included, and so we need all the girls we can get, and we have plenty of women that work at NASA. And so don't use that as an obstacle ever for whatever you choose to do in your life.
It's easy to feel pressure to fit one mold or be one thing. And I don't think you have to be. I think you can be a lot of things. I'm a mom. I'm also an art nerd slash IT geek. I love sports still, so I guess I'm an athlete. And I'm a lot of things. And I enjoy being all of those things. And it's fun, it's great.
I always say to definitely give it a chance. I know that it's hard. If it were easy, everyone would be doing it. But it's really worth the effort.
Stay motivated, turn to your family and to your friends and to your faith for help, and just don't give up.
Believe in yourself, because you really can do anything you set your mind to.